Right, Talitha, Brianna, good evening to both of you. In fact, Reverend Franklin Graham is going to be in a different continent on the first anniversary of his father's passing. He's going to be in Australia marking a different anniversary altogether, 60 years since Billy Graham preached there. I asked Franklin Graham today, what is February 21st, 2019 going to be like for him?
We're doing the work God's called us to do. And my father would not have wanted us sitting around here moping on that day. He would want us to be doing the work that our Father in heaven has called us to do. And that is to tell men and women how they can have their sins forgiven, to tell them about a God that loves them, that sent his Son from heaven to this earth to take our sins, that he rose from the grave, he's alive, and he'll come into each and every heart that is willing to trust him. And this is the message my father preached. This is the message I'll be preaching in Australia, and that's what my father would have wanted.
Not sure if you're familiar with the Higher Education Research Institute at UCLA, but this group has been conducting a nationwide survey of incoming college freshmen since the 1960s to kind of give a snapshot, a point in time of where the next generation of young people's attitudes are at any given moment. It's known as their SERP survey. Long story short, in 1966, 6.6% of respondents listed none as their religious affiliation. Now, 30.2% say they are atheist, agnostic, or have no religious affiliation at all. That's an increase of 358% in just over 50 years. What is your reaction to this apparent lack of faith in young people today?
Well, I put a lot of this blame on the Department of Education. We have spent billions of dollars out of Washington into the universities, and what we have is there is great pressure to take the faith away from the children as they come into universities. Their professors, it's almost a game to them to try to take away one's faith. And so it's sad that this is happening in our country.
No lack of faith here in Charlotte. In 2017, when Dr. Graham was still alive, 144,000 people visited his library. He died, as you mentioned, February 21st of 2018. That year, the attendance at the Billy Graham Library exploded to more than 214,000. Live tonight in Charlotte, Kenny Beck, WXII 12 News.